This video provides an in-depth analysis of a recent inquiry that focuses on short sellers and the behavior they exhibit in the stock market. In particular, we will investigate the circumstances surrounding Citadel, its Chief Executive Officer Ken Griffin, the AMC entertainment firm, and certain events that have occurred in the financial industry that have driven a large number of retail investors to demand enhanced responsibility and transparency. There is a growing number of individuals who are advocating for the government to conduct a thorough investigation of short-selling operations, allegations of market manipulation, and the impacts on normal investors financially. TURF, an investor, claims that the organization has gained a lot of traction as a result of its demand for a formal investigation to be conducted against Citadel Ken Griffin and their probable role in market manipulation. A total of over 21,000 signatures have been collected on the petition as of this moment, and supporters have raised $774 in order to spread the word. Due to the fact that the petition has not been replied to by the administration of Vice President Joe Biden, the reporters for the movement have requested that President-elect Donald Trump take control of the situation and initiate an investigation into the operations of Citadel and Griffin. Because of his experiences with alleged predatory techniques by businesses similar to Citadel, which have apparently harmed his own companies in addition to these attempts, there is even a proposal that Elon Musk could serve as an advisor in this probe. This is owing to the fact that Tesla has been involved in similar situations. To raise AW, this funding is supposed to be used. In addition, supporters are reaching out to Congressman Thomas Massey and other lawmakers in order to request that they take action against conduct that they consider to be unethical on the part of financial institutions. A growing number of retail investors are of the opinion that the market ought to be more equal, and that short selling ought to be declared in a more transparent manner. This request for an investigation reflects this growing conviction. Concerns are growing that some companies are abusing the practice of short selling in order to manipulate stock prices and cause harm to businesses, particularly those that have a sizable following of retail investors. Although short selling is legal and has valid uses in the stock market, such as facilitating price discovery and providing liquidity, there is a growing concern that some companies are abusing the practice. The purpose of the study is to investigate whether or whether these approaches unfairly target small investors, who are less capable of investing than financial organizations that have access to a greater amount of resources. And now looking back, we can see that Donald Trump and Ken Griffin have had arguments in the past that are comparable to the ones we are seeing now. Due to the fact that Trump has already condemned market manipulation, and because of his previous disagreements with Griffin, it is possible that he might consider investigating Citadel if he were to be asked to do so. According to a tweet from Unusual Whales, which suggests that Trump is aware of the claimed false rumors that have been propagated by some market manipulators and short sellers, this theory is consistent with the suggestion. There were reports or remarks that were incorrect, untrue, and most certainly unlawful concerning Trump selling shares in one of his firms, Truth Social. Truth Social. Trump has admitted that these rumors and statements were inaccurate. He stated unequivocally that these allegations were totally false, and that he had no intention of selling his shares at any point in the future. Although this declaration was made, the rumors were responsible for the decline in the stock price, which many people feel was the result of manipulation strategies. Over the past few weeks, we have witnessed instances of alleged manipulation that are comparable to those directed at Trump's companies, notably through nude. The use of computational algorithms and the fabrication of short sales in order to artificially inflate stock prices without prior notice, while traditional short selling involves selling shares that one does not actually own, short selling involves selling shares that one does not actually own. This generates an artificial supply, which can cause prices to fall. The use of these manipulative strategies can lead to artificial decreases in stock value, which are detrimental not only to the firm that is being targeted, but also to the investors in that company. The tweet from Unusual Whales, which asserts that these techniques have unfairly damaged the success of his company's shares, is a clear indication of Trump's irritation with these strategies. As a result of Trump's clarifying comment, the stock of DJT Digital World Acquisition Corp., which is affiliated with Truth Social, experienced a momentary increase of more than 10%. The price increase, on the other hand, resulted in a temporary pause in trading due to the volatility of the market. This has caused concerns to be raised because, in situations such as AMC and GME and GameStop, there have been instances in which stocks have surged much higher without a trading halt. For example, during the meme stock spike, we witnessed prices skyrocket by hundreds or even thousands of percent in a single day without encountering any pauses of the same kind. Nevertheless, in the case of DJT, a mere 10% increase was sufficient to halt trading, which has led many people to question whether these halts are genuinely intended to safeguard regular investors or whether they serve the interests of institutions that are too leveraged. When taking into consideration the function of these halts, it is highly probable that their objective is to protect financial institutions rather than to protect individual investors, as is commonly asserted. Trading halts have the potential to prevent the stock price from growing any higher, which might result in these institutions incurring losses in the event that certain shares experience a strong increase. This would put these institutions in jeopardy of experiencing severe financial losses. As we now turn our attention to the spending plan that AMC employs for its financial management, it is clear that the company is approaching its capital expenditures with a cautious attitude. Institutional investors that have placed significant bets against specific businesses and potentially lose billions of dollars if those stocks were to increase are protected by halts, according to the principle that underpins this practice. Investments in fixed assets, a strategy has been developed by the management of AMC that estimates that the yearly capital expenditure will be between $175 million and $225 million, which is equivalent to around $800 million to $1.4 billion, over a period of 4 to 7 years. It is essential to note that this strategy is extremely adaptable because AMC's expenditures will be determined by the performance of the box office, the amount of capital that is available, and other financial concerns. In order for AMC to successfully adapt to market swings or financial restraints, the company is working to align its spending with its income, liquidity levels, and strategies for debt management. AMC is making an effort to navigate its current financial issues, such as the amount of debt, and its conservative expenditure approach is a component of that effort. Despite the fact that expenditures on investments make up a significant portion of AMC's capital expenditures, the reduction of debt is the company's main objective, and it is also the recipient of some of this funds. It is possible that AMC may reap long-term benefits as a consequence of debt reduction. This is because reduced interest expenses will enable the company to invest in expansion in other sectors. AMC, for instance, has indicated that it intends to engage in projects such as installing Coca-Cola Freestyle machines in its theaters, which is expected to be a venture worth approximately $100 million. Another crucial factor that AMC must take into consideration is the path that the box office rebound will take. A significant factor that will determine whether or not AMC is able to make investments is the amount of money that is produced at the box office as the film industry continues to return to its previous level of health. An improved performance at the box office would not only result in an increase in AMC's revenue, but it would also enable the company to clear its debt and dedicate additional financing to other projects. This strategy demonstrates AMC's commitment to maintaining its financial health and highlights the company's cautious stance in the face of ongoing volatility in the entertainment industry. In addition, recent market trends suggest that the stock price of AMC may be under downward pressure due to factors that go beyond the company's financial performance. There was a significant dip in the price of AMC stock when the company reported its earnings for the third quarter, which Peter Hahn asserts was not a coincidence. According to the tweet that H sent out, despite the fact that AMC posted strong earnings, the company's shares closed the day at a price that was practically identical to what it had attained earlier in the day. In light of the fact that the most recent meeting of the Federal Open Market Committee FOCI resulted in a reduction of the interest rate by 25 basis points, AMC stands to gain from the potential reduction of its annual interest payments by approximately $5 million. Larger worries about manipulation in AMC's shares are consistent with this trend of price suppression, which is consistent with those concerns. Despite the fact that AMC has maintained its performance, there has been evidence of systemic prejudice. This is due to the fact that strong results have not resulted in an increase in the stock price of the firm. On the other hand, the stock prices of two other key industry competitors, IMAX and Cinemark, have climbed after their earnings reports. This is due